Thank you very much to Paul and Kate and Paul and Kelly and also Nadine. And thank you very much to our judges, Terry Burns and Aaron Stephen Jones, and also Stuart Laurie's going to be our judge here for our non-pro classic challenge here this morning, our third judge. Thank you very much to Samantha Stepnor, our arena director, all the boys in the backyards, thank you. Our timekeeper, Reg Nolan, our show secretary, Nadine McKenna, our live stream and videographer, Ray Cooper from Just Cutting, and welcome back to our viewers at home. And my name's Brent Cairn, and I'll be your official announcer once again here on day number 5 and music director and sound provider. And also our photographer, Bridget Christensen, as well. Thank you. And also thank you very much to the Australian Hotel, Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud Foresight, Mavericks Westerwear, Gidgee Eyewear, Cinch Australia, Double J Quarter Horses, Agrimix, and also Brett and Joy Peachy. As we're going to move into our non-pro classic challenge here today, here on day number 5, we've got a massive 5 herds, ladies and gentlemen, and all our viewers at home. And there's about 75 horses in total, so a massive non-pro classic that we'll see. This event brought to us by Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud. We've got $1,000 in added change, and a total of $23,000 is going to be paid out in this event. We'll have round number 2 of this event tomorrow, and then our final will feature on Friday, so that'll be around our third last event on the program on Friday, and the top 20 will make it back to finals, so it's a big time moment. Good luck to all our non-pro competitors here today here at the Blonde River Cutters Futurity Show for 2022. So Deborah Hinton from Tamworth's going to start things off with Rock and CD, owned by Deborah Hinton. This one's a mare that was sired by Highbrow CD out of Bridget Bardock, was bred by Deborah Hinton. It's going to be our first one to go, so good luck to Deborah here today. Then we've got a scratching at number 2, and so Dean Jones will be following Deborah. Then we have Craig Jones, Renee Richardson, so that'll be our first 4 here this morning. So head on over and grab yourself some breakfast or a coffee from our caterers once again here on day number 5. As we start getting to the business end, we'll start crowning some champions tomorrow afternoon for the Open Classic Final. But today we'll have 9 herds in total. We'll have the Non-Pro Classic Challenge, then we'll have the Non-Pro Futurity, and then we'll have the first round of the Snaffle Bit Futurity. So a big day ahead of 9 herds in total. Well, let's get the show rolling and see some great Non-Pro competitors and Snaffle Bit competitors as well. Good luck to Debbie Hinton. This is number 1 on the draw. Every time I Well, thank you very much, sir, Deb. That was Deborah Hinton from Tamworth. That was Rockin' CD, owned by Deborah Hinton. So that was Side by Highbrow CD out of Bridget Bar Dock. So our next four to see today, we'll see Dean Jones, Craig Jones, Renee Richardson, and Trudy Holden. That'll be our next four to see here today in show here in our non-pro classic. So marking a 208 there for Deborah, 208 on that showing, 208. So we'll now move to Dean Jones from Seymour, Victoria, number 3 on our draw sheet. This will be Girl Without Limits, owned by Dean and Julie Jones. This one's a side by Smooth as a Cat at a Sweet Barbie Doll. So next one to go. So good luck to Dean Jones, number 3 on our draw in the Non-Pro Classic Challenge, brought to us by our friends at the Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud. Thank you very much to Sunkiss for being involved with our Blonde River Cutters Futurity Show. Also thank you very much to our major sponsor, the Australian Hotel. Whether it's a range of TVs offering sport, their live music in the beer garden, their family-orientated bistro, or just stopping by for a cold schoonie, there is something suitable for everyone at the Aussie at St. George. Thank you very much there, Dean. That was Dean Jones from Seymour, Victoria. That was Girl Without Limits, owned by Dean Jones. So that one was Side by Smooth as a Cat at a Sweet Barbie Doll. So our next four we'll see today, showing in our non-pro classic challenge, we'll have Craig Jones, Renee Richardson, Trudy Holden, and Denise Milgate. So a total of 213 there for Dean on his round one's marking, 213. So we'll move to Craig Jones from Kingaroy, number 4 on the draw. This is Highly Justified, owned by Craig and Laurie Jones out of Kingaroy, Queensland. This one is Side by Highbrow CD out of Miss Havaway and was spread by Craig and Laurie Jones. So next one to go. So good luck to Craig here this morning in our non-pro classic challenge. Brought to us by friends at the Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud. So thank you very much to Foresight. To extend the athletic career of your horse, you need to care for their joints. Keep them performing at their best with Foresight. Buy it from your vet today. Thank you very much there, Craig. That was Craig Jones from Kingaroy. That was Highly Justified, owned by Craig and Laurie Jones. So that was Side by Highbrow CD out of Miss Havaway. So our next four we'll see to show today, we'll see Renee Richardson, Trudy Holden, Denise Milgate, then William Tapp. Marking a 210 there for Craig, 210. So we'll now move to Renee Richardson from Aroma, Queensland. Number five on the draw, this is Honky's Cat, owned by Mrs. Renee Richardson. This one's side by One Time Windstorm out of Kurrayong Cat, was bred by the Prize Cutting Horses. So next one to go. Also thank you very much to Sunkiss Quarter Horses as a breeding facility situated at Perga, Queensland. Possessing some very well-performed mares by some of the top Australian and international size. We believe in breeding versatile horses that have been well associated in both the cutting and cantdraft industries. For many years, we strive to breed to domestic and international stallions of quality. Our coming 2022 prodigy include Jewel Smart Ray from Metallic Rose, Metallus Cat from General's Daughter, with Metallic Cat to be born as well, and Smooth as a Cat and Don't Stop Believing, to name a few. Let's watch Renee Richardson, number five on the draw.
Don't be alone.
Thank you very much there, Renee. That was Renee Richardson from Roma, Queensland. That was number 5 on the draw, Honky's Cat, owned by Renee Richardson. That was sired by one-time Windstorm out of Currayong Cat. So our next four we'll see today, we'll see Trudy Holden, Denise Milgate, William Tapp, then Julie Sheedy. So 180-180 there for Renee, 180 as we'll now move to Trudy Holden from Cobram, Victoria. This will be Gardalicious, owned by Corey Holden. Next one across the show timeline, this one sired by Raisy Garter out of Duckalicious and was bred by Ian and Lisa Hindmarsh. So good luck to Trudy here this morning. Also lock in the dates of the Darling Downs Cutting Club Futurity Show. That's going to be happening from the 10th to the 17th of September at the Dolby Equestrian Centre, and the entries are closing today.
The seat of my big black jacked up truck, rolling on 35s, pretty girl by my side. You got that suntan skirt and boots, waiting on you to look my way and scoot. Your little hot self over here, girl, hand me another beer, yeah. All them other boys wanna wind you up and take you downtown, but you look like the kind that likes to take it way down, out where the cornrows grow, roll, roll my boat, floating down the Flint River, catch us up a little catfish dinner, gonna sound like a winner when I lay you down and love you right, yeah, that's my kind of night. Might sit down on my diamond plate tailgate, put in my country ride, hip-hop mixtape. Little Conway and little T-Pain might just make it rain. You can hang your T-shirt on a limb, hit that bank and we can ease on in. Soak us up a little moonlight, you know I know what you like, yeah. Wanna wind you up and take you downtown, but you look like the kind that likes to take it way out, out where the cornrows grow, roll, roll my boat, floating down the Flint River, catch us up a little catfish dinner, gonna sound like a winner when I lay you down and love you right, yeah, that's my kind of night, yeah, that's my kind of night. My kind of, your kind, is this kind of night. We dance in the dark and your lips land on mine.
Thank you very much there, Trudy. That was Trudy Holden from Cobram, Victoria. That was Gardalicious, owned by Corey Holden. So Gardalicious was sired by Raisy Garter out of Duckalicious. So our next four to show today we'll have Denise Milgate, then we'll have William Tapp, Julie Sheedy, then we'll have Jason Blanchett. That'll be our next four. So ladies and gentlemen, 222 there for Trudy, so a round of applause for her this morning, 222. So we'll move to Denise Milgate from Felton South, number 7 on the draw. This is Metallic Jewel, owned by David Heath. This one's a side by Metallic Cat at a Tia Dual Ray and was bred by David Heath. Thank you very much there, Denise. That was Denise Milgate from Felton South. And that was Metallic Jewel, owned by David Heath. So Metallic Jewel was side by Metallic Cat at a Tia Jewel Ray. So our next four to show today were William Tapp, Julie Sheedy, Jason Blanchett, then Michael Dunbar. So 183 there for Denise, 183. So we'll now move to William Tapp's going to be next to go. The man that makes his home at Wowan, Queensland. Number 8 on the draw. This is Classy and Hot, owned by William Tapp. This one's side by Hotspot out of Classy. Reagan was Ray Girl, was bred by William Tapp. So lock in the dates of the Victorian Futurity from the 27th of September to the 2nd of October. That'll be at Bungalong, Victoria. So head on down to Victoria.
Calling my baby, she comes over and the party begins.
Thank you very much there, William. That was Willie Tapp from Wawan, Queensland. That was number 8 on the draw. That was Classy and Hot, owned by William Tapp. So Classy and Hot was signed by Hotspot out of Classy Ray Girl. Also, to keep up the NCHA, check out their website at ncha.com.au for results, events and standings, or their social media page on Facebook as well. So marking a 210 there for William, 210 for that showing, 210. So we'll now move to Julie Sheedy from Glen Innes, New South Wales, number 9 on the draw. This is Dual Talic, owned by Rex and Julie Sheedy out of Glen Innes. This one sired by Jewel Ray out of Sweet Talic, was bred by Rex and Julie Sheedy. So next one to go here today in our non-pro classic challenge, brought to us by our friends at the Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud. You can like their social media page on Facebook, where you can talk to Jackson Gray, their resident trainer. Thank you very much there, Julie. That was Julie Sheedy from Glen Innes, New South Wales. That was Dual Talic, owned by Rex and Julie Sheedy. That was sired by Jewel Ray at a Sweet Talic. So our next, we'll have five more to go, actually, in this herd. We'll have Jason Blanchard, Michael Dunbar, Ryder Yates, Mark Ranger, and Anna Summers. So 180 there for Julie, 180 on that showing. So we'll now move to Jason Blanchard. It's going to be next to go. Thank you very much to Mavericks Western Wear. Maverick stocks a wide variety of well-known international brands. These brands include Saratelli felt hats, men's and ladies' cinch apparel, Ben Edel slim and rock and roll denim apparel, and Double C company jeans, belay boots, Maverick straw, and also felt hats as well. So Jason Blanchard from Taree, New South Wales, going to be next to go. Number 11 on the draw, Spinster's Playboy, owned by Jason Blanchard. So next one to go. So this one's sired by Juice Lena out of a Spinster's Tribute, was bred by Eva Hartman.
feel alright. I pull my blue jeans on, I pull my blue jeans on. Ch-ch- I pull my blue jeans on, I pull my blue jeans on. Ch-ch- ch-ch- it's the weekend, and I know that you're free. So pull on your jeans and come on out with me. Oh, 'cause I need to have you near me. I need to feel you close to me. Ch-ch- to have you near me, I need to feel you close to me. You and me, we'll go motorbike riding in the sun and the wind and the rain. I got money in my pocket, I got a tiger in my tank, and I'm king of the road again. I meet you in the usual place. You don't need a except your pretty face. Alright. I pull my blue jeans on, I pull my old blue jeans on. Ch-ch- I pull my blue jeans on, I pull my old blue jeans on. Ch-ch- ch-ch- here we go, mama.
Thank you very much, sir, Jason. That was Jason Blanchard from Taree, New South Wales. Number 11 on the draw, that was Spinster's Playboy, owned by Jason. So Spinster's Playboy was sired by Juice Lena out of Spinster's Tribute. So we've got four more to go in this herd. Michael Dunbar, Ryder Yates, Mark Ranger, then Anna Summers. A wind down herd number one. So marking a 200 there for Jason, 200 on that showing, 200. So we'll now move to Michael Dunbar, is going to be next to go. Thank you very much, Agitchi Eyewear, Australian designed and owned. Remember to protect, polarise, perform. Check out their website at www.agitchieyes.com. So Michael Dunbar from Toogoolawa, Queensland. This is SDP Coco Ray, owned by the MND Rural Propriety Limited. This one sired by TR Jewelry out of Dara Coco's Preview and was bred by the Dario family.
Here, hold my beer. I wouldn't blame you if you wanted to fight. If you want it later, we could take it outside. But for now, do me a favor and hold my beer while I kiss your girlfriend, 'cause she needs a real man and not a boy like you. You're missing, but I do. So here, hold my beer.
Thank you very much there, Michael. That was Michael Dunbar from Tugulawa, Queensland. That was SDP Coco Ray, owned by the M&D Rural Propriety Limited. Was signed by TR Duray out of Dara Coco's Preview. So 180 there for Michael, 180 on that showing, 180. So we've got three more to show in our first herd of five. The Non-Pro Classic Challenge. We'll have Ryder Yates, Mark Ranger, then Anna Summers. So Ryder Yates is going to be next to go. The man that makes his home at Emerald, number 13 on the draw. This is Raisin Roses, owned by the Yates Family Trust. This one being sired by EB's Phalaris out of Yulgabar, Playing Stylish. Was bred by Gavin and Rowena Yates out of Emerald, Queensland. Be our next one to go. So good luck to Ryder here today, number 13 on the draw. So thank you very much to Cinch Australia. Lead, don't follow. Cinch products are cultivated through the hard work and dedication with all involved, and Cinch strives to offer quality, stylish attire that is a great fit today. Thank you very much, Sir Ryder. That was Ryder Yates from Emerald, Queensland. That was Raisin Roses, owned by the Yates Family Trust. That was signed by EB's Phalaris out of Yulgabar, Playing Stylish. Also, make sure you like the Cinch Australia pages on Facebook, Instagram and TikTok to keep up with the journey of Cinch Australia. Well, 218 there for Ryder, 218, so that'll be our second high marking of the round so far. So a round of applause for Ryder here today. So 218. So we'll move to Mark Range, is going to be our next to go, our second last competitor in herd number one. This will be Hard Boon Baby, owned by Mark Ranger. This one's side by Hard At Henry at a Jazzy Little Boon. So our next one to go. So good luck to Mark, New South Wales competitor, number 14 on the draw in our non-pro classic challenge, brought to us by our friends at Sunkiss Quarter Horse Stud. About $23,000 in total prize money. Also on Friday night, all our competitors, breeders and trainers, welcome to come on up to the bar facilities, all welcome. They'll be doing the draw for the Open Futurity and also a sausage sizzle and also the bar facility. So that'll be after the Open Derby final on Friday night. So come on up to the bar facilities and join us, as we'll have a cow cutter as well, so you can buy one of those competitors in the Open Futurity. Thank you very much there, Mark. That was Mark Ranger with Hard Boon Baby, owned by Mark Ranger. That was side by Hard At Henry at a Jazzy Little Boon. So we've got one more to show before we change out the herd. Will be Anna Summers. We'll wind things down at herd number one, so we can have the Demi Patini herd settling team to please be on standby. That'll be greatly appreciated. So 205 there for Mark, 205, as we'll move to Anna Summers from Bendemeer, New South Wales. This will be El Saludo, owned by Mrs. Leanne Summers from Bendemeer. So thank you very much to Double J Quarter Horses, where Mare Power Matters, based in Kapunda, South Australia. We pride ourselves on producing quality quarter horses for the cow horse industry. Get in touch with our agents Lincoln Brad or Dean Holden today and find out what stock we have available for sale. Good luck to Anna Summers right now. She's going to wind down herd number one. So in between herds, make sure you go and check out our wonderful traders on show, Casey Sattery, and also Mavericks Westerwear. We'll grab yourself some coffee or tea or some breakfast here this morning from our great caterers here this week. But let's watch number 15 on the draw.
Country fiesta.
Hey y'all, let's ride. Party going on the riverside. Hey y'all, jump in, let your head down, go off the deep end. Cold beer, hot things, nothing but a chicken wing. Get your girl screaming with that southern drawl. Hey y'all.
Cut offs, that's right. Sugar so sweet, the chickens won't buy.
Thank you very much there, Anna. That was Anna Summers from Bendemeer, New South Wales. That was El Saludo, owned by Mrs. Leanne Summers. Well, a round of applause to those competitors in herd number one there, ladies and gentlemen, here today on day number five on our Wednesday here at the Blonde River Cutters Futurity Show. As I'll get that last score, if we can have Demi Patini herd settling team to please be on standby, that'll be greatly appreciated. So 193 there for Anna, 193. So time to stretch your legs there, cutting fans. And we'll be back very soon for herd number two. So the Demi Patini herd settling team to please be on standby. And we'll be seeing more non-pro classic challenge action very soon.